Hello friends, my name is Pranav. In this lesson we are going to discuss about excretion in human beings. As you can see, this excretory system in human beings. Let's start. The excretory system of human beings includes a pair of kidneys, these two kidneys, a pair of ureters, left and right, this one ureter, this one is another ureter, a urinary bladder, this one is urinary bladder, and a urethra, this is urethra. Kidneys are located in the abdomen on one side of the backbone. Kidneys are located in the abdomen on either side of the backbone. Urine produced in the kidneys passes through the ureters into the urinary bladder, where it is stored until it is released through the urethra. So our kidneys, these two kidneys, they filter blood and remove waste substances. These waste substances, we call them urea or uric acid, come through these ureters, these two ureters, and then accumulate in the urinary bladder. From urinary bladder, these waste products are released through the urethra. Now the question is, how is urine produced? The purpose of making urine is to filter out waste products from the blood. As our blood is a connective tissue, it carries oxygen, carbon dioxide, glucose, fat in dissolved form to all the cells of the body. These cells generate waste products, and these waste products are removed by filtration. This filtration work is done by kidneys. Just as carbon dioxide is removed from the blood in the lungs, nitrogenous waste such as urea or uric acid are removed from blood in the kidneys. As you know, our lungs filter carbon dioxide. Since carbon dioxide is of no use for us and is the waste product of cellular respiration, in the same way urea and uric acid are waste which are filtered out by the kidney. It is then no surprise that the basic filtration unit in the kidneys, like in the lungs, is a cluster of very thin walled blood capillaries. As you can see here in this diagram, these are capillaries and these are known as glomerulus. Each capillary cluster in the kidney is associated with the cup-shaped end of the tube that collects the filtered urine. Capillaries means thin blood vessels. You can see these capillaries, which are known as glomerulus, are associated with the cup-shaped end, which is known as Bowman's capsule. This Bowman's capsule collects the filtered urine and processes the urine through these tubes. This is the diagram of a nephron. Each kidney has large numbers of these filtration units called nephrons. So this is the diagram of nephron. Packed close together. These nephrons are packed close. Some substances in the initial filtrate such as glucose, amino acid, salts and a major amount of water are selectively reabsorbed as the urine flows along the tube. As you can see, it is a branch of renal artery. These renal arteries, you can see this arrow, these renal arteries carries blood to this nephron. Then this blood is filtered through this tube. So during the filtration, substances such as glucose, amino acids, salts and water are reabsorbed as the urine flows along the tube. So the urine has to travel through these tubes and then it is collected through this collecting duct. This coil part is called proximal distal tubule since it is closer to the Bowman's capsule, and this tubule part is called distal convoluted tubule, or together they are known as tubular part of nephron. This loop, this descending loop and this ascending loop is known as loop of Henle. The amount of water reabsorbed depends on how much excess water there is in the body and how much of dissolved waste there is to be excreted. So it's not like that you will produce same amount of urine every day. It depends on the amount of water present in your body. If the amount of water is less, then the process of filtration is optimized by the kidney. The urine forming in each kidney eventually enters a long tube, the ureter. As we have seen here, these two ureters. So the urine is produced in the kidney and then it reaches the urinary bladder through two ureters, left and right ureter. Which connects the kidney with the urinary bladder. You can see the urinary bladder. It connects these two ureters, left and right ureter. Urine is stored in the urinary bladder until the pressure of the expanded bladder leads to the arch to pass it out through the urethra. So this urinary bladder is under the control of muscle, that means neurons are there. So you can sense the feeling which is sensitive actually. We can control the arch for a while, but ultimately we have to pass it through urethra. You can see this is urethra. It comes out, the urine comes out through urethra. It is the passage of urine. The bladder is muscular, so it is under nervous control, as we have discussed elsewhere. As a result, we can easily control the arch to urinate. The bladder is muscular, so it is under nervous control. As we have discussed elsewhere, as a result, we can easily control the arch to urinate. Renal artery ke through se blood aata hai. Bowman capsule ye wala hai. कप शेप स्ट्रक्चर, और ये जो ग्लोमेरुलस है ये कैपिलरी है।
रेने लॉटरी की तरह से ब्लड आता है, ये ग्लोमेरुलस है जिसको जो कैपिलरीज है, कैपिलरीज मतलब थिन ब्लड वेसल्स, ये बाउमेंस कैप्सूल है जो इसको हग किया हुआ है, ऐसा लग रहा है इससे कप लाइक स्ट्रक्चर। इस रेने लॉटरी की तरह से ब्लड आता है और ये ब्लड फिर फिल्टर होता है, कौन करता है फिल्टर, वोमन कैप्सूल, ये एक ट्यूब की तरह है, ये ट्यूब के साथ कनेक्टेड है, आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पर, ये जो पहला ट्यूब यहाँ पर कॉइल है इसका नाम है प्रॉक्सिमल कन्वोल्यूटेड ट्यूब। फिर एक ट्यूब नीचे जाता है, ऐसे जा रहा है नीचे, इसके थ्रू से जो फिर जो वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स है वो भी नीचे जाएगा। फिर यहाँ पर जो आप जो ट्यूब्स हैं यहाँ पर आप देख रहे हैं आर्टरी, ये जो आर्टरी आप देख रहे हैं इसमें से ब्लड फिल्टर होगा, फिल्टर होके इस ब्लड में से जितना भी वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट है सब बाहर आ जाएगा, फिर यहाँ पर इसके थ्रू से जाएगा, इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं डिसेंडिंग लूप ऑफ हेनले, क्योंकि ये नीचे की तरफ आ रहा है तो डिसेंडिंग, नीचे की तरफ आ रहा है तो डिसेंडिंग, और ये है असेंडिंग लूप ऑफ हेनले क्योंकि ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है। यहाँ पर अच्छे से एब्जॉर्प्शन होता है, जितना भी ज़्यादा अगर वाटर ले लिया है किडनी में नेफ्रन में तो फिर वो लौटा देता है ब्लड में, अगर कम लिया है तो फिर ज़्यादा ले लेता है, ऑप्टिमाइज करता है, ऑप्टिमाइजेशन होता है यहाँ पर। फिर ये ऊपर की तरफ जाता है, यहाँ पर एक कॉइल ट्यूब फिर से आप देख रहे हैं, ये दोनों अलग अलग हैं एक साथ नहीं है, आपको ये डायग्राम भी प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा, कम से कम 3-4 बार आप प्रैक्टिस कर लीजिए। इसको हम लोग कन्वोल्यूटेड ट्यूब्यूल बोलते हैं क्योंकि ये बाउमेन कैप्सूल से दूर है। फिर ये एक कलेक्टिंग डक्ट के साथ अटैच्ड है, यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हो और भी अटैचमेंट दिया हुआ है, मतलब इसके साथ ये जो है इसके साथ और एक नेफ्रन कनेक्टेड है, इसके साथ और एक नेफ्रन कनेक्टेड है, इसके साथ और एक नेफ्रन कनेक्टेड है, तो बहुत सारा नेफ्रन एक साथ कनेक्टेड है और सब ब्लड को फिल्टर करके उसमें से वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट निकाल के यहाँ पर डाल रहे हैं, कलेक्टिंग डक्ट में डाल रहे हैं, जो यूरिनरी ब्लैडर में जाके बाद में जमा हो जाएगा, फिर यूरेथ्रा से बाहर आ जाएगा। तो हम लोग इसीलिए बोलते हैं नेफ्रन को किडनी का स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट। नेफ्रन का कुछ आइडिया मिलेगा। वीडियो अच्छा लगा तो सब्सक्राइब करें, लाइक करें, कमेंट करें और शेयर करें।